Well, and just to tell us more on this developing story, I'm now joined by our reporter Fatia Mohammed Nuru, who has just returned from that refugee camp, that is Kakuma refugee camp. So many people have been saying that it needs to be closed, but it's not, that is not going to happen anytime soon because, of course, the political crisis in the youngest nation in Africa, that is South Sudan. Fatia, good evening, and I'm sure you have some facts and figures about Kakuma for us.
A very good evening to you, Yusuf. Yes, we have the figures for you. But first off, Kakuma is the second largest refugee camp in the country. And of course, the UN agencies have created public spaces and the Kalo Bay settlement that we'll be telling you more about in a bit. Yeah, so now to just tell you more, I'd like to tell you about the numbers of the refugee status update in Kakuma refugee camp. Now, the Kakuma camp was established in 1992, and this following the arrival of the Lost Boys of Sudan. Now, if you can remember history, the Lost Boys of Sudan is basically the children who fled the conflict from Sudan to Ethiopia and then later on came to Kenya to seek a refuge. Now, Kakuma is also divided into four zones. There's Kakuma 1, 2, 3, and 4 that caters for the refugees in Kakuma refugee camp. Now, the new settlement's Kalo Bay camp was established in June 2015, and its estimated capacity was at 45,000. Now, something interesting about Kalo Bay is the UNHCR had requested the government to allocate some piece of land because the Kakuma refugee camp had surpassed its capacity of over 58,000 individuals. Now, on to the next now is now the numbers of refugees in the asylum or the refugee camps in the country. Now, we have 488,460 refugees and asylum seekers in Kenya. That is both Kakuma and Dadaab. And also for the refugees hosted at Kakuma camp and Kalo Bay is 185,867. But now for the new settlement, that is the Kalo Bay settlement, is 38,561, which has not surpassed the 45,000 capacity that was already set by the UN. Now, on to the next is the population of refugees. Now, the South Sudan refugees lead in the number of refugees, and this is because of the conflict that is going on in that country. Remember, that's the youngest nation, but also there's a renewed conflict that has led to the number of refugees increasing. Now, it's followed by Somalia, that is with 34,371. Remember, that country is faced by the terrorist group Al-Shabaab. Now, finally, there is Ethiopia that has 10,473 refugees. Remember, this country in the recent past has been facing a lot of political instability, and the Hailemariam Desalegn prime minister resigned, and then now they have a new prime minister, that is Abiy Ahmed from the Oromia clan. Now, finally, the shelters that are there in the refugee camp. Now, in Kakuma, you have 41,623, and this is out of the four zones that are there in Kakuma. And now in the Kalo Bay, you have the temporary and the permanent. For the temporary, you have 8,277, while the permanent, you have 284. Now, basically, permanent means they have started building houses with stones and also bricks, yeah? But the temporary means there is just tents and tents and just temporary buildings. But that's all we had for you. Back to you, Yusuf.
Thank you very much, Fatia, for that comprehensive update. And of course, reports are that, you know, the numbers of refugees there might continue increasing because mainly because of something that we've already mentioned, the political crisis there in South Sudan. Thanks a lot, Fatia, as you make your debut as well.